Hi, a subscriber requested a how to practice type tutorial for Chopin Study Opus 25 number 6 in double thirds to update my old tutorial on this study. This video is an introduction to this new tutorial. The writer J.K. Rowling advised, give yourself achievable goals. Over the years, as we advance with experience on our chosen musical instrument, not necessarily the piano, each and every time we play, we voluntarily look for or involuntarily discover specific areas needing improvement. I think this is equally true whether a beginner, advanced, or a concert pianist. Musical goals relative to our experience remain at some distance, as when reached, they constantly renew themselves. With 25-6 in mind, for most of us, just playing the double thirds at a moderate tempo is the first milestone to reach. When 25-6 is under the fingers at tempo, we instinctively search for ways to make it musical. Chopin, the composer, wrote the study for us to overcome the technical difficulties with sufficient practice so listeners would only hear music, not a study. I'd like to read you a description of Rachmaninoff practicing 25-6 by someone listening nearby. This account gives us, I think, valuable insights into how to practice this study. There's no explanation by Rachmaninoff himself regarding this seemingly unusual practice session for a great pianist with a flawless technique, so I'd like to offer a possible explanation. First, that description. I could not believe my ears. Rachmaninoff was practicing Chopin's etude in thirds, but at such a snail's pace that it took a while to recognise it because so much time elapsed between each finger stroke. Fascinated, I clocked this remarkable exhibition. 20 seconds per bar was his pace for almost an hour, while I waited, riveted to the spot, quite unable to ring the bell. Now, I'll run through a few bars of 25-6 to remind you of the average performance tempo. Why would Rachmaninoff, who knew this study intimately, inside out, upside down, take 20 seconds to practice each bar? My theory. Let's remind ourselves, for the purpose of this exercise, what legato basically is.
The three stages of legato are 1. First note played. 2. Second note played while holding the preceding note down. 3. Only after both notes are ringing together do we release the first note.
If you're watching this advanced tutorial, you know what legato is, of course. However, although the principle may seem basic, 25-6 poses the legato challenge of challenges. I suggest Rachmaninoff was playing slowly to observe closely his fingers playing double thirds in legato. Let's call the double third an interval and imagine Rachmaninoff at the piano looking down at his fingers.
He plays the first interval. He holds this interval as he plays the second interval. He observes the brief moment both intervals are held down together side by side, the resonance mix. He releases the first interval and is now holding just the second. He plays the third interval while holding down the second. He observes the moment when they are held down together and their resonance mix, and so on. To do this and be aware of the legato action of each interval change carefully takes about 20 seconds a bar.
Opus 25:6 is more than a study in the rapid execution of double third chromatic scales. It is that, but also the ultimate study in finger legato. It's only with the benefit of hindsight we know how best to begin. So if you're beginning this study yourself, I hope this tutorial helps. Thanks for watching.